This day they put in salary here, everybody sitting here would be paying taxes. Because everyone sitting here has capacity to earn salary. Yes or no? Every one of you, whatever be the number, 15,000, 20,000, 30,000, whatever be the number, as per your age, skill, qualification, right now you have capacity to earn. Yes or no? But you chose not to earn salary, but to learn more and then earn more. But do you have capacity of earning salary? Yes. Thank God, capacity is not taxable under the head salary. Otherwise, you and me were supposed to pay tax even if there was no salary. Hello? Yes. And therefore, in salary head, salary is taxable only if there is a salary. So salary head is taxing only a real income. Thank God. In PGBP, if I don't have mood to take lecture for 1 month, I sat at my home, did some farming activity, taught my students. My students means those people who are going to stay with me in Gurukul. I just taught them something like farming, sport, yoga, not teaching. Hello. So I did not earn anything in that particular month. You understand? Hello? But am I having capacity to earn? Yes. If I work somewhere, can I earn 2 lakh rupees, 3 lakh rupees per month? Yes. And if I earn that much income, then I have to pay tax. Right now I did not earn. Government will say that is your problem, sir. You might have earned. You are not showing it to us. Hello? You might have earned. Dilip sir is your friend. You might have earned, you might have taken the cash. And you are showing that you are not earning, that is your problem. You have capacity to earn 3 lakh rupees, we will take tax on. Hello?
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Thank God they are not doing it in business. Hello? In your house you have 10 lakh. Assume you have 10 lakh in your house. Can you open FD?
Yes.
But you thought you will not open FD. You don't need FD. You have kept that 10 lakh for some other use, and that use is not income. So it is there. Alright. You are not putting into bank, you are not putting it into share market, you don't trust banking system, so you are not putting in saving bank, you are just keeping the money idle. That money, is that money earning anything for you? No. But can it earn? Does have capacity to earn something? Even if you open a simple FD, you will get 8% return per annum. 80,000 rupees you could have earned. Hello? Kama sakta tha 80,000? You are not earning, that is your problem. Hello? Okay? We will assume that you might have earned, you might have actually earned, we don't know it. So we will tax the capacity. Thank God they are not taxing same thing in IFOS. Hello? So thank God the capacity is not taxable. Pankaj classes here, Elite Siksha. Look at the capacity. Let's take 40 student is the capacity, or 50 student is the capacity of this classroom. Right now we are 35. Hello? You're getting my point? So on how, like how many student fees we should pay tax? Actual 35, capacity 50. You tell me. 35, why? Because you wanted to pay tax on real income. You wanted to pay tax on? And they are also taking on real income. But if they put this particular logic in house, this business, then what will happen? 50 will become taxable. Evening after 5:30, more number of students are going to join your batch. Then 65 students are sitting here now. Then, come on, capacity is 50, but 65 is going to sit. Then, 65, because this head is taxing, this head is taxing actual. Whether it is below capacity or whether it is above capacity. You understand? All other heads are taxing that only. Real income. What is the speciality of house property head? It is taxing capacity or actual rent. Hello? Capacity or whichever is. And this is capacity. This is the expected rent from Government of India. Hello? Now, this particular rent we have to compare with actual rent. This particular rent we have to compare with actual rent. Actual rent, say for example 60,000. Okay, I'm showing actually cannot be 60. You understand? I'm showing to government how much? 60. Government will take whichever is higher. Sometimes we say zero, nil, hai nahi. Still capacity is taxable. Sometimes we say 80, then 120 is taxable. Sometimes we will show 180. 180 will become taxable. That amount is known as gross annual value. That amount is known as
gross annual value.
Okay, 1,80,000. From gross annual value, they give a deduction of municipal taxes. They give deduction of municipal taxes. But municipal taxes paid. Central government says, you pay municipal taxes, then only I will give you deduction. If municipal taxes are outstanding, how will you claim deduction? Don't come here shameless. You need to pay tax. Because they are providing you water, they are keeping your city clean, they are constructing and maintaining roads for you, they are constructing local gardens. Hello? They need to earn money. You pay them and then claim deduction. You pay them and then? You are getting my point? So what is taxable in our head? Hello, tell me, what is taxable in our head? Rent earning capacity. The focus is on what? Rent earning capacity. Not real income, it is notional income. It's not real income, it is? And that notional income is known as net annual value. Let's take example, you pay 10,000 tax and the net amount will be 1,70,000. Anything if you subtract from gross, the next amount will become net annual value. And this is a computational mechanism which is given under section 23. Before break I was teaching you section 22. Now I was teaching you section 23. Hello? Do you understand section 23? Come on. Tell me, how do we compute expected rent? Very simple. There are 4 rent in this particular chart. Out of 4, 3 are not real. They are just comparative figures. Alright. So the first thing that you will find in question is fair rent or municipal value. Whatever comes first. Okay. Fair rent or municipal value, whichever is higher. Alright, that number we will compare with standard rent. We will take whichever is lower. That whichever is lower amount is known as expected rent. Expected rent compare with actual rent. Between this government expectation and your actual, what is net amount? Hello, what will come outside? Whichever is higher. Alright, so that amount is GAV, gross annual value. Again, tell me, how gross annual value? How do we get gross annual value? Simple. Comparing fair rent with municipal value, whichever is higher. Alright. That amount we will compare with standard rent. Then whichever is lower. That amount is known as expected rent. Expected rent compare with actual rent. Expected rent, actual rent, whichever is higher. That amount is gross annual value. From gross annual value, subtract municipal tax. That amount will be net annual value. Am I clear? Hello. Very simple. Alright. We will do one question quickly after this. Okay. One more manipulation I wanted to teach, then I have to teach that deemed owner. No. Deemed later property I will teach, but deemed owner. Okay. The very basic evasion that they do is this. Okay. There is the owner. Owner of a property. Alright. And this owner is a businessman. This owner is a earning more than 10 lakh. You understand, earning more than 10 lakh means he's already in 30% tax slab. After 10 lakh, what is the tax slab in India? 30%. And this owner is having spouse. Owner is having spouse. Okay. She's housewife. Like, she don't work. She don't earn. Her income is zero. And owner has to give some money to her to run a family. Yes or no? Now I am the tenant of the property. He is the owner and the tenant. Owner was doing agreement with me. Everything was done. Hello? Towards the end, owner will say, listen, give me cash. I'll say, I can't give you cash, because to give you black, I must have black. I earn in white, so I will spend in white. Then he said, oh, then you have to, if you are giving check, then you please give check on my wife's name. Then I said, sir, if you are doing agreement with me, hello, then you are legal owner. And if I give rent to somebody else, then I don't mind. I will give, what, there's nothing wrong. But can I give you free consultancy, sir? Free consultancy. I'm chartered, no, so I can give free consultancy. Alright. I said, sir, department will easily catch you. Easily, quickly. Because your wife is earning rent without having property. Her balance sheet is nil. As per municipal record of Mumbai Municipal Corporation, she doesn't have any. And you are showing to income tax department that she is earning rent. Do you understand why he wanted to take rent on her name? There is only one reason, to evade tax. And how will he evade tax? He's showing income to department, but she will not pay tax up to 2.5 lakhs. Yes or no? After 2.5 lakhs, she will pay tax, but only 5%. After 5 lakhs, she will pay tax at the rate of?
20%.
If it was directly accounted in his account, then the rent was supposed to tax at 30%. 30% directly came to 0% or 5%. Isn't it evasion? Although they are showing it to department. Because check, once it is entered into bank, you have to show it to department. Am I clear? You understood the problem? Then what he did? Okay, legal ownership is a problem. No. I will gift house property to my wife. What will he do? Hello, he will gift the house property to wife. Only one agreement he will bring. Wife doesn't know it. He will just say, darling, come here. He will like sign from some paper. I am giving this out. From today, you are the owner of house. She will be very happy. Today, she will cook something good. Sweets. And she will call her amma. You know what? Today, he gifted me house. Today, I am the owner of the house. Hello? She is happy. She is saying that it is love, attachment, feelings. No, this is what? Evasion. This is tax. Now, I have to pay rent to her. Yes or no? She is the legal owner of the property now?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
But who negotiated with me? Owner. Who is collecting rent from me? Owner. Who is maintaining my property? If something happens, I don't call her, I call him. If tomorrow I don't pay rent, if I do something nonsense, then who will come and throw me outside the property? Owner. Who will find new owner, a new tenant? Owner. Can she sell this property? She is the legal owner now. Can she sell this property to somebody else? She's a legal owner. Bolo na.
Yes.
Sell karne dega kya ye? Kaan ke niche khich ke tere baap ki property hai. Legal owner. But is she controlling the property? Hello?
Yes.
No, she is not controlling the property. And therefore, who is the real owner? Paper ki baat mat karo. Drishyam hai wo. Tumko dikhaya ja raha hai kuch aur. Hai kuch aur. Don't see what is shown. See, try to see the reality. Go into reality. Do not see the form. In account, they teach you this concept. Substance over legal form. Hello? Try to see substance in real life and this life also. Alright. Whenever you go get into relationship, your boyfriend or your girlfriend will only tell you those things that you can accept. Okay. Beyond that, nobody is going to share. Hello? Not only that, you are also doing the same thing. You will try to show the face that she accept. Hello? You are animal inside, that you will not show. You understand? Now what is your responsibility? Try to show what is real. Then what is your intelligence? Try to see real. Do not believe in what you see. Don't believe. Because whatever you see is created for you. The situation was created for you. Okay. There are a lot of movies like this. Yes or no? Drishyam is one of the movie. That whose movie? Ajay Devgan?
Yeah.
Drishyam movie. In that movie, who killed that guy? But what was the legal form? Legally, can they prove it?
No.
No. You understand? Towards the end, they showed that only. No. Legally, he did not kill. Really? He killed. Alright. And then evidence were created in the law. You can understand a criminal will always produce evidence. A tax evader will have better evidence than normal assessee. Hello? A tax evader will have more evidence than? Because he is creating consciously. He knows that how department will capture me. Okay, yeah. You as the cost accountant, I as the chartered accountant, we together have some social responsibility that we need to understand reality first. Step one, understand reality. Do not believe in whatever is told to you, whatever is said to you, whatever is given to you. Try to find out the real income of the assessee. Advise him, sir, mat karo chori. Sir, teen property aapke naam pe. Show it to department. If you don't show it, why assessee will not show three property to department? Assessee will show only one. Why? Because balance two will become either taxable if they are let out, or it will become deemed to be let out. What assessee will tell you, you know? Are delete that wo do property ka record dikhao hi mat na bhai. Hello. You will tell to your assessee, sir, I'm okay, I will delete it, I can't control you. But if you don't show it, and if they find it, which they are going to, for sure, because Modi uncle is still there, and he's going to come one more time. Alright, and law is getting stronger and stronger day by day. Hello, in Mumbai, every day there is some raid. Every single day. You go on any business premises, you go on, you know that, there are a lot of markets in town. Crawford Market, Zaveri Bazaar. You go in these business areas. Alright. You will see at least 2-3 shops are closed. And some policeman is standing outside. What is going on? Hello? Come on, tell me what is going on. Raid. Okay. In Mumbai's at least income tax department is so active that every day there is some kind of raid. Every day. Okay. They are running out of time. And because this is election year, they are doing it more. They wanted to show this much amount we collected. Hello? You understand? So you tell that SSE, sir, we are ready to hide it. You wanted to hide it, we will hide it. You can't force us. But if they find it, sir, only one thing is that they will do. You will be getting covered under aggregation of income chapter, sir. Do you remember aggregation of income chapter? Section 68, 69, 69A, 69B, 69C, 69D. 60% is the tax rate, sir, on undisclosed properties. 60. Benami Property Act has been passed. Modi uncle has already passed one act, Benami Properties Act. This is Benami. Transferring property to child, transferring property to spouse is a Benami. Illegal hai. Ye sab kya hai? There was a time this was the tax evasion, only tax problem. Now it is illegal, punishable offense. In tax they will take 60% tax, 25% surcharge and 4% sales, which effectively come to 78%. Then there is a 10% penalty. Hello? And then there is an imprisonment up to 7 years. Hello? What will you tell your father today? Start paying tax on rent on array, or try to hide it. Come on, tell me. Start paying. Because if you don't show it voluntarily, one day they will find it. One day they will find it. I'm telling you. You travel every day without ticket. You travel every day. Jogeshwari, I haven't seen TC for last 1 month, I guess. I don't think so, it is there. But once, yeah, with that belief, can you travel every day? With an assumption, no, there is no TC today also. No TC today. You might travel 364 days without ticket. One day they will find you. If you are hiding rental income, it's like traveling in a train without ticket. By assumption, TC will not catch. But I am promising you, one day will come that they will catch. And when they catch, and if you can't exist it, there are ways of exist, but if you can't, because Modi uncle is putting a lot of pressure on department now. Alright. And digitalization is happening. So manipulation has gone to zero, kind of. Alright. Possible. Possibilities are there that you will be under a lot of trouble. So don't earn black money through house property. Sir, how central government will come to know that he is having three properties? Your properties are registered on your name. Yes or no? That property detail is with your registrar. How much time department will take? to ask for that record. Please send us this, this is RCC, his record. Registrar will give it in 2 minutes because everything is digitalization now. And gradually they are going to link your PAN card with Aadhaar card with bank. You understand? Aadhaar card with properties with car, mobile number. If they wanted to read your past chat, they can read your past chat just by putting Aadhaar number. Okay. And in this world, you are living by assumption that they will not catch us. Now that is the wrong assumption now. I'm not saying they will catch for the sure or immediately, not may not be immediately, but maybe 1 year down the line, 2 years down the line, 5 years down the line, someday. Now these old income tax officers are about to get retired. And new income tax officers like you, young blood, they are hiring it. And young people are not corrupt immediately. They take time to become corrupt. Alright. And some of them for getting appointed now, they are having nationalism so much in their blood. They don't want money. They wanted to work for a nation. They wanted to die for a nation. Some singhams are there. Alright. And then they will start catching us. And they are actually catching. Raids are taking place. That means income tax department is not sleeping at home. They are active cell. They are collecting data. हाँ, you might not be a target one because अपन लोगों को क्या target करने का? In Mumbai, if they have to target, will they target you?
No.
Not now, but maybe in future. In right now, you don't have black. Sir, black. We don't even have
white.
So they are not running behind you, but people who are having white and black, they are trying to target them. Okay, this head is anti-tax evasion head. Okay, so we will start again our practical discussion. Any doubt if you have, please ask. You can stop.